So good afternoon, one and all. Before introducing myself, I would like to thank FOSSI team for giving this wonderful opportunity for us to present our work here. After so many ups and downs, we have got this opportunity here. And since this is our first conference we are attending, we are very excited about it. And without wasting much time, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Megha Pujamat. I'm from B.V. Bhum Reddy College of Hubli, Karnataka. I'm from Karnataka. And these all have worked with along with me for this whatever we are presenting today. And Professor A.B. Raju sir has already presented how usage of Scilab and Xcos in our curriculum. A self-study component, we have simulated some circuits in power electronics, and that is what we are presenting here. Coming to modeling, from a given particular circuit, we design some equations. They may be ordinary equations or non-linear equations or partial differential equations. We have many numerical techniques for solving these equations. Using Xcos models, we have analyzed this function. So there are many other solutions for analyzing this, but why we have adopted Scilab is, as we have all discussed from yesterday, the advantages of Scilab. It is very advantageous since it is a free and open source software, especially for students like us. And we have a theoretical approach towards whenever we use Scilab software, we have some analytical approach towards a problem that we'll be seeing later. And here we are presenting power electronics converters, which we have modeled using Daniel Hart textbook, which is a reference book for us. We have modeled some converters and inverters, and that's what we are showing here. So this first one is the buck converter. As we know, it gives a reduced output. There are some design assumptions, that is, inductor current should be always continuous. And this is what the circuit diagram is. We have modeled the Xcos model using some design equations. These are the given parameters which we have here. V not equal to, those are the given parameters, and we have assumed some things and calculated the value of duty ratio and all those R and L and C. So using this, we have modeled in Xcos. That is how we modeled the method. How we modeled is, signal, we have used signal builder, that is, it generates triangular wave that is given, and from there we generate a pulse. So this is given to the this and V input we have multiplied and then given. So whenever the circuit look at the circuit, there is a switch here. So whenever it is in the off condition, we multiply 1 minus S. Whenever it is in the on condition, we multiply S to the inductor voltage. So that is how we have given inductor voltage V out to the oscilloscope and current, inductor current. So this is how we get. The first plot explains the output voltage. So we are getting this ripple. We can reduce this ripple by varying the capacitor value. So as capacitor increases, this ripple can be reduced. And below one is the current, inductor current. It should be continuous. We have here continuous current. For a circuit to work in continuous conduction mode, it is necessary that there must be some average current in the inductor. So this is the continuous current. So coming to the buck boost converter, here when D value is less than 0.5, it acts as a buck converter, and when it is more than 0.5, it acts as a boost converter. That is, we get increased value of the output voltage. So it's, the modeling of this is also just like a buck converter itself. So here is the model of Xcos. The same follows how we have done with a buck converter. Only thing, the design equations vary, and L and C values we have given here. So this is how we get the output. The first one is the inductor current. Here also we can see that it is a continuous current. And the below one is the voltage, output voltage. These ripples can be reduced by changing C and L values. So next one is single phase inverter. Here this DC input is converted to the AC output. So this is the inverter, and we get the pulse width modulated output. This is what the output we get. This also we have designed here. You can see the equations here. S1 minus S2, that is nothing but the switch. So using these equations in the XCOS model, we have that expression there. Using this, you can get the output voltage. So that modeling of that equation, getting that equation itself is necessary in modeling XCOS. So this is the inverter. So we have modeled many inverters like as such, and analysis of when we change the variables, what happens to the output voltage can be seen very nicely in XCOS. I would like to show an example, like for students like us, if they give us a circuit and they tell us to simulate and we get an output, that much is not necessary. We need to know how the parameters are affecting the output voltage. Suppose here this is the inductor value, L value. Suppose I increase the inductor value. So what happens is my output ripple will get reduced. Since I have increased my inductor value, my inductor current will get reduced, ripple will get reduced here. We can observe that. So the ripple will go on decreasing as we increase L and C value. This is how we analyze the circuits, power electronic circuits. So we have already used Scilab and XCOS in our previous projects. So even in the upcoming projects, we are using Scilab and looking at interfacing Scilab with Arduino and making it a hardware project. So this was all about our work, and thank you very much for giving an opportunity for us to submit here. So if any questions, then I can.
Thank you. Any questions? Thanks for the presentation.
Very briefly, you can also use the electrical palette in XCOS. There are resistors and things like that to make your electrical circuits.
Yes, we have used even those. We have used.
I have a question regarding the simulation which you have done. How have you decided the values of inductor and capacitor in the converter?
That is what is the design is. I'll just show you my design. See, you're asking me about inverter, right?
Any of the inverter or converter.
So input voltage will be given to us, or you can assume that, and using that you have to design the inductor and the resistor value and capacitor value also. You have many equations related, like buck converter and buck boost converter, you have different equations. So using those, when you design, you get a equation to model it in XCOS. That is how we have got the values.
Okay. And what would be the switching frequency which you would have taken for the converter?
Like I have designed for D. So when we make it as 1 by D, then we get frequency there itself. We have not, just we have given some values, random values, and got the output.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.